If you're short on toilet paper during this lockdown, don't you worry. We've got the next best thing. It started out, we're all in this together. What happened? Australia went into lockdown, then Melbourne had a second brutal lockdown. The evidence emerged that the best way to lock down was to go short, sharp and hard. But of course, Gladys Berejiklian, the Premier of New South Wales, preferred to take advice from business as well as the medical advice. She played Russian roulette with the people of New South Wales, and now we're certainly all in this together, in lockdown. Now, fortunately, I was out of Sydney when the lockdown happened, so I've been in regional New South Wales. Unfortunately, that means that I've had access to Sky News Australia for free. The Maddies on Sky News After Dark are now bagging Gladys Berejiklian and Scott Morrison, like the sirens in Homer's Iliad, calling the sailors to their deaths on the rocks, espousing the business interests. No lockdown, make it open as possible, keep businesses going, because the economy and because business is more important than people, that essentially we just let people die because that's what the market or the economy wants. That's what's good for business. Now, you only have to look at the funding of the corporate media. It's funded by ads from large corporations and a lot of government ad spending as well. These are the revenue streams which allow these businesses like News Corp to survive. And so they pay heed to the opinions of a business. And on the other side, of course, is the medical advice. The business advice and the medical advice. Now, you can't really have both. The result is that the pandemic has been brutally politicized. It has led to poor decision making. They're being pulled both ways, as the latest news poll shows, with Labor now in the ascendancy and the coalition taking a hit because of the mismanagement of the pandemic. Now, according to the Australian's lead story, PM must regain initiative as brutal ALP tactics take toll. It was an effort to have a whack, as they do every day, at Labor, while ignoring how badly the government is performing. Scott Morrison is the target of a coordinated and unbridled political campaign directed by the state Labor premiers and its federal opposition, and it's working. They're blaming it on Labor. Reality is that Labor does have a coordinated campaign. It's a coordinated campaign to keep their heads down, to let the coalition blow itself up. And it appears to be working. Labor even gave the nod to stage 3 tax cuts in recent days. This is tax cuts for the wealthiest working Australians, something which isn't very Labor in its essence at all. But they don't want to have an argument. They don't have to do anything. Why would they? They might end up on the front pages themselves, in place of the increasingly negative coverage of the lady who would never find love again, the damsel in distress. All they need to do is keep their heads down. Now, there is no perfect solution. The new Delta variant, we are, in a sense, in uncharted territory with this virulent strain. But we weren't in uncharted territory with Gladys, who chose to follow the business advice over the health advice. Where to from here? There's uncertainty on the economic front. It's now contracting again, the economy. On the lockdown front, there's no end particularly in sight at the moment. We just wait for the numbers to come out every day. We've got a vaccine rollout, a bit like John Howard's cricket ball deliveries. We've got Labor allowing the government to blow itself up. And on the media front, there is certainty. We know what's going to happen. The main 3 media organisations, the corporate and government funded media, 7, 9 and News Corp, are going to continue to muddy the waters, to play politics for the Morrison government. That will go on. So apparently we're all in this together. Well, maybe not all of us. Like this video if you'd like to see Gladys joining us all in following the health advice too.